Range rule of thumb for understanding standard deviation. The range rule of thumb is a crude but simple tool for understanding and interpreting standard deviation. The vast majority, such as 95%, of sample values lie within two standard deviations of the mean. Significantly low values are the mean minus two standard deviations or lower. Significantly high values are the mean plus two standard deviations or higher. Values not significant are between the mean minus two standard deviations and the mean plus two standard deviations. For large data and representative samples, we use X bar and S in place of mu and sigma in the notation above. And here's a pictorial representation. This is identifying the values that are significantly low. This is significantly high, and this is the relationship between the mean and the standard deviation to identify those numbers that are significant from those that are not. Here's an example. Based on a data set in the text appendix, body temperatures of adults have a mean of 98.2 degrees Fahrenheit and a standard deviation of 0.62 degrees Fahrenheit. The question is an adult body temperature of 100 degrees Fahrenheit significantly or unusually low, or significantly or unusually high? To determine that, first we find the boundaries between significant and not significant values, and we do that by finding the mean of the sample, which is given, and the standard deviation, and then we subtract 2 times the standard deviation from the mean, and we end up with this value for the significantly low boundary. And then for the significantly high boundary, we find the mean plus 2 standard deviations, which ends up as 99.44 degrees Fahrenheit in this particular problem, which is the boundary that separates significantly high numbers from not significant numbers. So if I look at this on a number line, I have a boundary here of 96.96 degrees Fahrenheit and a boundary here of 99.44 degrees Fahrenheit. These are unusually low values for temperature. These are unusually high or significantly high values for temperature. So where does the value of 100 fit on this number line? If I were to make a mark to identify 100 degrees Fahrenheit, I would be somewhere in the green shaded section. And therefore, I do see that since the 100 degrees Fahrenheit is above the 99.4 degrees Fahrenheit, then this body temperature is considered to be significantly or unusually high.